Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Good afternoon everyone. We are from group 11. We want to present about policies and regulation in biotechnology both in Indonesia and abroad. Our members are Alifian Rusani Putra with student number 208, Muhammad Rayan Akbar with student number 210, Humam Yusuf Abu Salam with student number 215, Dian Adona Yoga with student number 217, and Abdul Miljam Syati with student number 229. Next.
Okay, the background is obtaining food security is a complex and difficult task depending on many interrelated factors encompassing political, social, and technical matters. Biotechnology application integrated with conventional system hold a promise in increasing agricultural production. One tool in the area of biotechnology is genetic engineering to produce transgenic crops. The presence of transgenic crops and their products has triggered public controversial reactions. Concern about negative effects resulting from transgenic products has caused several countries to produce, approve, and implement regulation that guarantee the safe utilization of these modern technology products so that they will not endanger consumers and will not damage natural resources. In this presentation, we will present about regulation in modern biotechnology. Development of regulation related to genetically engineered product in Indonesia, biotechnology laws and regulation in Indonesia, and international law regulation regarding biotechnology. The first one is regulation in modern biotechnology. Regulation in modern biotechnology. Genetically engineered products, or PRG, are the result of the application of modern biotechnology. In the Republic of Indonesia Government Regulation Number 21 of 2015 concerning the biosafety of genetically engineered products, PRG is defined as living organism, their parts and or their process product that have new genetic structures as a result of the application of modern biotechnology. Meanwhile, modern biotechnology is defined as the application of genetic engineering techniques, which include in vitro nucleic acid techniques and cell fusion of two or more types of organisms outside taxonomic kinship.
Genetic engineering technology can be applied to plants, animals, fish, and microorganisms. PRG plants are plants resulting from the applications of genetic engineering techniques. PRG animals are animals resulting from the applications of genetic engineering techniques, for most of all, of their lives on land. PRG fish are fish resources and other aquatic biota species whose life cycle is mostly or wholly in water, resulting from the applications of genetic engineering techniques. PRG microorganisms are microorganisms resulting from the applications of genetic engineering techniques. Next, we are going to talk about development of regulations related to genetically engineered products in Indonesia. The Conventions of Biological Diversity with Law Number 5 of 1994, regulated provisions regarding the safety of the applications of modern biotechnology in clauses Article 8, letter G, Article 17, and Article 19, paragraph 3, and paragraph 4, which mandate the applications of a protocol within KKH to regulate cross-border movement, handling, and utilizations of genetically engineered products as a product of modern biotechnology. By adhering to the mandate of the articles mentioned above, the parties to the conventions began negotiating the protocols on biosafety, which is known as the Cartagena Protocol. The aim is to ensure the adequate level of protections in the terms of transit, handling and safe use of transboundary movement of GMOs. To avoid adverse effects on the preservation and sustainable use of biodiversity, as well as a risk to human health.
And then, in the food law number 18, 2012, government affirms that for everyone who will produce food or carry out activities or food production process using raw material, food additives, and or other material produced from food genetic engineering, FBG food safety approval must have been granted by government. Provision regarding the process for obtaining food safety approval. Provision regarding requirement and principles for research and development and research for genetic engineering methods shall be regulated in government regulation. The government will impose administrative sanction on every person who violates this provision. Next. Third, biotechnology law in regulation in Indonesia. Next. Several law, government regulation of the Ministry of Agriculture regarding the safe utilization of biotechnology produce have been established since 1996. This enacted law and regulation consists of rules that are both general and specific, covering laws and regulations for biotechnology produce are safe for environment, safe to be consumed, and safe to be used.
And then Republic of Indonesia Act number 7 of 1996 regarding food. This act comprises of 65 chapters where the regulation of biotechnology products are contained in chapter 13 and 58. Chapter 13 regulates the safe utilization of food before distribution. It states that any person who produces food utilizing raw material, food additive and or other additive using genetically modified material or food production process utilizing genetically modified material have to be inspected and tested for human health before its distribution for human consumption. Chapter 58 regulates that any person who willfully violates the above law will be punished with maximum imprisonment of 3 years and a maximum fine of 360 million rupiah. Next. Republic of Indonesia Act number 29 of 2000 regarding the protection of plant varieties. This act comprises of 76 chapters where the regulation of biotechnology products are contained in chapter 11. This chapter regulates that a person or a legal entity can apply for plant variety protection right. The application for genetically modified varieties or biotechnology products should include the description of molecular varieties, genetic stability of the proposed product, parental reproductive system, the existence of vegetative compound that will be environmentally destructive or compound that will be hazardous for human health, and also ways to rectify them in case of irregularities. This application must also be accompanied by a written statement from a competent authority that the product is safe for the environment and human health. Next. Republic of Indonesia Act number 28 of 2004 regarding food safety, quality and nutrition. This act comprises of 54 chapters wherein the regulation of biotechnology products are contained in chapter 14, which states that any food utilizing raw material, food additive and or other additive using genetically modified material or food production process utilizing genetically modified material has to be inspected and tested for human health before its distribution for human consumption. In addition, description also state that the inspection should include genetic information such as general description of food, description of the host as well as its use as food, description of donor organism, description of genetic modification, genetic characterization, and safety information. Safety for food information must include substantial equivalence, nutritional change, allergic reaction, and toxicity. Next. And then topic number 5 is international law regulation regarding biotechnology. Next.
Okay, now we talk about United Nations Convention of on Biological Diversity 1992. UNCBD is the first global agreement that is comprehensive and covers all aspects of biodiversity, genetic and research and ecosystem. This convention is the result of the Environment Conference held in Rio de Janeiro, Brazil, in 1992. More than 190 countries have signed this convention. However, this convention became effective after 90 days, with the fulfillment of the condition for ratification, namely the existence of 30 countries that signed the convention, in this case Mongolia, which co-signed it on September 30, 1993. Thus, this convention on biological diversity became effective on December 29, 1993, after 18 months since it was opened for signature on KTT Earth 1992. This article 2 in the UNCBD states the definition of biotechnology as the application of technology that use biological system, life things or their derivatives to make or modify product or process for specific use. And then this opened the opportunity for a new protocol that specifically regulates biotechnology, which includes the use, handling, and movement between regions of genetically modified organism. The proposed protocol is called the Biosafety Protocol or Biosafety Protocol. Next. Next is Copenhagen Protocol on Biosafety to the Convention on Biological Diversity on 2000. The protocol for biological safety has been widely discussed at the international level. This proposed protocol is called the Biosafety Protocol or the Biosafety Protocol, which since the first meeting of the parties in Nassau, Bahama, has been discussed and is still the subject debate at COP2 in Jakarta, November 1995, and COP3 in Buenos Aires, Argentina, until finally at COP5 in 2000, which was in Nairobi, Kenya. This protocol was adopted under the name Copenhagen Protocol on Biosafety to the Convention on Biological Diversity. Next, in contrast to what is stated in the Convention on Biological Diversity, the definition of biotechnology in this protocol states in Article 3, which states modern biotechnology is the application of 1. In the first is in vitro nucleic acid technique, include recombinant deoxyribonucleic acid, or DNA, and direct injection of nucleic acid into cell or organelles, or fusion of cells that are outside the taxonomic family, which overcome natural physiological, reproductive or combination barriers, and which are not a technique used in traditional breeding and selection. Okay, thank you for our presentation.